Hi, I'm here to talk to you about 2020. And I'm actually talking about 2020 as the birth of a decade, because we're now going into 2020 to 2030. And that's a very important time in the cosmos. And I'm going to share about both the numerology and the astrology. Now, you may have tuned in because it said I'm talking about Aries and I'm talking about Sagittarius or whatever sign you are or whatever ascendant sign you are. I am first going to talk about it in general, and then I'm going to turn to talking to you as an individual about your individual sign. So bear with me. It's important for you to understand the backdrop of what we're talking about. So 2020 is 20 plus 20 is 40. And that adds up to a 4. And in tarot, 4 is the Emperor. And so we're in a year. Emperor is about stability, logic, order. And so we're in a year where we're going to have matters of stability being very important to us. Another 4 is 13, 1 plus 3, and it's the death card. Now, the death card is not about death, it's about transformation. And so that's going to fit with what we've got over the year, is transformation. And then ultimately, we have a 22, and I'm showing you the cards. I'm showing you the card for the death card, and the 22 is called the Fool. It's a master number. It's a major important card about having faith that the universe is going to have your back in the year of number that is a 44. One of the ways we see that is that we have the 0 behind 2 and 0 behind 4. And when a number has a 0 behind it, it's like a blessing number. So, but if you fall into the trap of getting all worried because all the transformation that's going on, it can cause you to upset the fact that you've got a blessing number here. So I want to inform you and get you sort of prepared to be able to keep your own peace. And the 40th card in a deck of tarot cards is called the Page of Cups. And the Page of Cups is looking at what's going on, but you notice the water behind her is very calm. 40 is a number about being able to look at what's going on and staying calm. If you happen to be looking at this and you're in the United States, you're well aware that we're going to have plenty of contentious news going on. 2020 is an election year, and we've already got plenty of contention, and it's probably only going to get worse. Remember to look at what's going on and stay calm. And so that's one of the things we're talking about. So I'm going to show you the astrology chart for 2020. And what's important in that, in astrology, Capricorn is very important. Every new year, the sun is in Capricorn. So that's just, there's nothing new about that, that it's New Year's and the sun is in Capricorn. But what is new is I have this chart here, and you notice at the bottom of the chart, I have one arrow after another arrow. There's what's known as a stellium, and a stellium is three or more planets in the same sign. And when we hit New Year's, this is the chart for January 1st. When we hit New Year's, we have just a whole, what other word to use, but a glob of planets all together. And they are important planets, and there are we're going to talk about what to do to make the most and to stay calm. Remember, the goal is to look at what's going on, but to stay calm. And so there are a few things that I'm going to pay attention to. In an astrology chart, there's something called the North Node and the South Node. The North Node is where you grow to, where you should go to, but it's because it's new territory. The South Node is where you've been successful in previous lifetimes, and you keep wanting to go back to the South Node. Well, now the South Node is all part of this stellium. And so they've got, we've got all these planets ganged up together, and then we have at the top of the chart the North Node. So this lonely North Node, all by itself, without any other planets with it, is where we're supposed to go, but we have all this energy down at the bottom of the chart calling us, and the North Node is right at the top of the chart, so it's just really calling us to follow through and do what the North Node wants us to do. But in this group, in the stellium group, in the group of planets in Capricorn, we've got Pluto and Saturn. And Pluto is the planet of transformation, it's the lord of the underworld, and Saturn is the lord of karma. And we're going to see in the news this year many changes in governments. There could be, when we look at times in history when Pluto and Saturn have been together, it has been the time when there have been significant wars started. World War I started when Pluto and Saturn were together. The Cold War started when Pluto and Saturn were together. In 1982-83, it only happens every 34 to 38 years. And so it's not like it happens every day. And right now it's happening with all these planets together. Now, the last time it happened in Capricorn was 1517-18, around there. And that was the beginning of the Protestant Reformation, where there was a split between the Catholic Church and the Protestant Church. The good news is that because that happened, then we have the United States, where people came to have freedom of religion. So today, at least in the United States, you can worship God in most any possible way you could ever want to figure out to do. That's carrying forward 500 years. There's nobody alive who has lived through Pluto and Saturn in Capricorn. We don't know what it is, but we do know that we live in a very contentious time. And so, what's some more information? There are a couple of other things, and that's why I have some planets circled. And when I start talking about your individual sign, I'm going to talk about those, what the additional things. We've got Mars. Remember I mentioned war. Mars is the planet that's the warrior planet. So but in your own life, you don't want to start a war this year. So let's know what Mars is about. And we've got Uranus. Uranus is the planet of surprises. Where are you going to hit surprises in the coming year? And then I'm going to talk about Chiron, because Chiron is about healing. And the North Node that I didn't mention yet, the North Node is about healing. So going in the direction, you see how we have two people sharing, they're sharing at equal quality level, and they're showing that healing comes when you share with other people. When we talk about the South Node, the South Node is in Capricorn, and here, and we've got all these planets in Capricorn. Capricorn is about juggling practical matters, it's about building big structures, and it's about protecting big structures. But if you get overprotective, it's really to focus on what can you do to help others to heal. So we're going to talk about that for each sign. I know that some of you may not be familiar with charts. This chart that I'm using to illustrate for the general is from Greenwich, England at 1201 on New Year's Eve. That's the beginning, it's the birth chart of a decade for the world. And as world citizens, we want to give you as much information as possible to help you as an Aries or a Taurus or a Gemini. So now, here's the beginning background. Now we'll start with talking to you about your particular sign. That's the first.